Yo, what's up everyone? It's Smart Biz and Tech by Zashapu. Today, we're diving into the future of driving. We're talking hands-free, eyes-off-the-road driving. Mercedes-Benz is pushing the boundaries with their Level 3 autonomous driving system. Is this the tech that finally leapfrogs Tesla's autopilot? And what about those robo-taxis we keep hearing about? In this video, we're going to break down exactly what Level 3 autonomy means, how Mercedes is implementing it, and where Tesla and those robo-taxi companies fit into all of this. Stick around because things are about to get autonomous. Okay, so before we get into the Mercedes of it all, let's talk about Level 3 autonomy. Level 3, often called conditional automation, is where things get really interesting. This is the level where your car can actually take over completely, handling all the driving tasks, but only under specific conditions. Think highway driving in heavy traffic, or maybe even those late-night drives when you just want to zone out. And here's the key difference. It's legal to take your eyes off the road. Unlike Tesla's autopilot or even their full self-driving, which is still considered Level 2, Level 3 means the car is actually in control. The system will still let you know when it needs you to take over, and you've got to be ready to grab the wheel. But for those moments when it's engaged, you can actually check out of driving and let the car do its thing. That's the promise of Level 3. And Mercedes is one of the first to bring it to the masses. Alright, so Mercedes is calling their Level 3 system Drive Pilot, and it's available on their flagship S-Class and their electric EQS sedan. Mercedes went all in on the hardware here. We're talking LiDAR sensors, radar, and a whole suite of cameras providing a 360-degree view around the car. Mercedes is also using high-resolution 3D maps and sensors that can detect things like road moisture. Right now, it's designed to work on highways at speeds up to 40 miles per hour. Imagine being stuck in rush hour, but instead of stressing, you're able to actually relax. Drive Pilot is already approved for use on mapped highways in Germany, and they're rapidly getting the green light in other areas, including parts of the US. Mercedes is really pushing the boundaries here, and it's exciting to see Level 3 autonomy finally making its way into the hands of drivers. So what is it actually like to use Drive Pilot in the real world? Earlier this year, Mercedes invited journalists to Germany to experience Drive Pilot firsthand. They're driving down the Autobahn and hit a traffic jam. Instead of white-knuckling the steering wheel, the driver activates Drive Pilot. The car takes over completely, smoothly adjusting speed and keeping a safe distance. The driver is able to take their hands off the wheel and their eyes off the road. They're checking their phone, messing around with the infotainment system. They even have time to grab a drink. Eventually, the traffic starts to clear and the car knows it's time for the human to take back control. Seeing Drive Pilot in action really drives home just how far autonomous driving has come. Chapter 4. Mercedes vs. Tesla vs. Robotaxis, the Autonomy Battle Royale. Alright, so we've established that Mercedes is doing some seriously impressive stuff with Drive Pilot, but where does this leave everyone else? Let's break down the competition. First up, we've got Tesla, the company that's become synonymous with autonomous driving. Their full self-driving, or FSD, system is still considered Level 2. That means that even with FSD engaged, the driver is still required to keep their hands on the wheel and their eyes on the road at all times. Tesla is constantly pushing software updates and making improvements, but for now, it's not quite in the same league as Drive Pilot. Then you've got the robo-taxi companies like Waymo and Cruise. They're focused on Level 4 autonomy, which means their vehicles are completely driverless, but only within specific, geographically fenced areas. So, where does that leave Mercedes? They're bridging the gap between Level 2 systems like Tesla's autopilot and the hyper-specific Level 4 robo-taxis. Mercedes is bringing true autonomy to a personal car that you can actually buy and drive yourself. And that's a big deal. Chapter 5, Level 3 and Beyond, the road to widespread autonomy. So, we've seen what Mercedes is doing, but the big question is, how long until this level of autonomy becomes more widespread? The truth is, Level 3 is still in its early stages. Besides Mercedes, only Honda has launched a limited Level 3 system, and it's only available in Japan for now. But that doesn't mean the rest of the automotive world is standing still. Companies like BMW, Audi, and a whole bunch of tech startups are pouring billions of dollars into developing their own autonomous driving systems. One of the biggest hurdles right now is regulation. governments around the world are understandably cautious about letting cars drive themselves, and getting approval for Level 3 systems can be a long and complicated process. But the tide is definitely turning. As more companies demonstrate the safety and reliability of their systems, we're likely to see regulations loosen up. It's no longer a question of if, but when Level 3 autonomy will become the norm, and Mercedes is leading the charge. Chapter 6, The Future is Now, Embracing the Autonomous Revolution. So, what does all of this mean for the future of driving? We're on the cusp of a major shift in the way we think about transportation. Over the next few years, expect to see Level 3 autonomy expand to more highways and more car models. It's not going to be limited to luxury brands like Mercedes for long. We'll start seeing it trickle down to more affordable vehicles, making this technology accessible to a much wider range of drivers. Imagine a world where your daily commute becomes an opportunity to relax, catch up on work, or even enjoy some entertainment. Autonomous driving has the potential to make our roads significantly safer. Human error is a factor in the vast majority of accidents, and by taking the human out of the equation, we can drastically reduce the number of collisions. We're entering a new era of driving, one where cars are becoming more intelligent, more capable, and more integrated into our lives than ever before. And honestly, I, for one, am incredibly excited to see where this road takes us. Outro: The Race to Autonomy. So there you have it, the Mercedes-Benz Drive Pilot, a real production-ready Level 3 autonomous driving system that's already on the roads today. It's clear that Mercedes is pushing the boundaries of what's possible, and they're setting a new standard for the entire automotive industry. But the big question is, who do you think is going to win the race to full autonomy? Is it going to be Mercedes with their cautious but steady approach? Tesla with their bold promises and constant software updates? Or maybe one of the robotaxi companies quietly building their driverless empires? Let me know your thoughts down in the comments below. And while you're at it, hit that subscribe button and that notification bell so you don't miss out on any of our future deep dives into the world of tech. Until next time, keep it locked to Smart Biz and Tech by Zishapu Global.